My dear friend in Christ, haven't we all asked this question sometime in our life? Why should a good God allow suffering? Why should a good God allow suffering? And this is an eternal question rattling the human mind. Yet there are so many incidents in our own lives, sometimes appearing bad, but turn out what we ourselves call a blessing in disguise. In some ways, it does answer that eternal question. And here's a story about a king who enjoyed the company and the wisdom of Jewish rabbis as much as he enjoyed his forest jaunts. As a treat, one day he took a rabbi with him into the forest and encouraged him to try his shooting skills. The rabbi said, "Sire, I am only a rabbi. I never held a gun in my life." But after much encouragement, the rabbi then took the gun. He went a few furlongs into the forest. Then the rabbi pulled the trigger. He suddenly heard a scream. He had accidentally shot the king's arm, and the king's respect turned into rage against the rabbi, and he had the rabbi thrown in the darkest dungeon. With a wounded arm, the adventurous king once again went into the forest. But now danger struck. Cannibals captured him. His soldiers escaped. He was sure to be eaten by the cannibals. But the cannibal chief screamed aloud, "Look, we have a bad omen. This creature's body is wounded. Let's go, lest evil befall us." The king then headed straight to the rabbi in the dungeon, saying, "Holy rabbi, if you did not shoot at me, I wouldn't be alive today." And then he elevated the rabbi to the highest ranks of advisors. But the rabbi said, "Thank you, sire. I would have been eaten by those cannibals if you did not throw me into this dark dungeon." My dear friend in Christ, when you truly love God, good things happen somewhere to someone, even when you can't comprehend divine providence. Sample this. You pray for rains to cease, but a poor farmer prays for rains. You pray for relief from scorching sun, but the poor farmer prays for sun to dry his grain. You pray for a salary raise, but a youngster is praying for a job. You pray for a better house, but a refugee somewhere is praying for a land to call his own. Though mysterious, God's ways always, always serve a loving purpose. Think about Matthew chapter 5, verse 45. "For he makes his sun rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust." And about Romans 8:28, "All things work together for good for those who love God." So, my dear friend in Christ, with real faith, you can count your blessings in disguise, because God loves you eternally. Have a good and godly day.